Habits that'll make you successful. The most asked question is there a key to success? Is there a recipe that I can follow that'll help me become successful? Well, unfortunately, there's none. But if you could talk for a couple minutes with the millionaires of this world, there are some common things that they do regularly. So in today's video, we'll talk about those habits that you can also practice to make you successful too. We've learned about these habits for the first time from Robert Kiyosaki's book, Rich Dad, Poor Dad. So today we'll be quoting from his book. Number 1. Read books. Did you know that CEOs read an average of 30 books a year? I'm not talking about those school readings. I'm talking about books that'll help you understand the financial world, books that'll develop you as a person, and change your mindset. Robert Kiyosaki said in his book, if you're still doing what mommy and daddy said for you to do, like go to school, get a job, and save money, you're losing. But why are you losing? It's because in school, you learn how to be an employee. With books, you can learn how to be an entrepreneur. Number 2, learn from failure. When you were still in school, what was your biggest fear? Failing your exams and getting low grades? Let's see what Robert says about failure. He said, winners are not afraid of losing, but losers are. Failure is a part of the process of success. People who avoid failure also avoid success. If you never fail, you'll never get out of your comfort zone. And if you don't leave your comfort zone, you'll never be able to explore new opportunities. But if you fail, the smartest thing to do is to learn from that. Number 3. Make a daily schedule. The night before, create a to-do list with the important tasks you need to accomplish for the day. But make sure these tasks are those that will change your life long-term. Let me explain what I mean. For example, your goal is to be healthier. Then, your task is to run for 2 miles every day. Or, let's say you want to start a business. Then your tasks are to start learning, reading books, looking for opportunities, asking questions like, what problem can I solve with my business idea? Then you'll have a better idea if you're ready for this big step. But remember, if you want to achieve something long-term, create short-term achievements that lead up to your big goal. Number 4. Talk less and listen more. Let me ask you something. Has it ever happened to you that when you meet someone new, you immediately forget their name seconds after meeting them? Why does that happen? It's most likely because you didn't pay attention. If you want to be successful, you need to start listening to people. People will like you if you're able to help them or provide them with solutions to their problems or needs. There's a great book that talks about this by Dale Carnegie, How to Win Friends and Influence People. This book is a must-read if you want to be successful. Number 5. Start investing in assets and hold off on spending on luxury items. Let me tell you a story. I had a friend who started to work after university with no experience and earned $2,000. It wasn't enough and it was hard to live off that amount of money. After 2 to 3 years, he switched jobs and started earning $5,000. But even then, he was still poor. Why? Because when his salary would come in, he'd spend it on things he didn't really need. So he had no savings. If you have money, start investing. Invest in something that'll make you more money. And when you reach this point, Robert Kiyosaki says, your money is working for you. He also said, often, the more money you make, the more money you spend. That's why more money doesn't make you rich. Assets make you rich. Number 6. Start making friends. There's an interesting fact. People tend to have very similar friends. If you're a doctor, I'm sure you have a number of friends who are doctors too. Or if you're a teacher, most likely most of your friends are teachers too. What if you're a millionaire? If you want to be a millionaire, you need to have friends like this also. You're influenced by the people you're with. Choose your friends wisely because they will influence the life you live. Number 7. Get up early. I know this sounds annoying, but hear me out. This is what most business owners do. When you go to sleep at 10 p.m. and wake up at 5 a.m., you can do 2 hours of work already until 7 a.m., until the rest of your household wakes up. You're already way ahead of them. Also, there are bad side effects if you sleep less than 6 hours or if you sleep more than 8 hours. Some include long-term sicknesses like cancer, diabetes, etc. So take care of yourself. Aim to have a healthy body and a healthy mind. Waking up early helps promote a positive attitude. Why? Because you're able to achieve a difficult task and strengthen your discipline. And this will also influence the rest of your day. With this positivity comes a happier outlook, and thus more productivity. It's best not to do anything too energy-consuming past 7 p.m. Just chill. Read a chapter from your favorite book, be with your loved ones, and prepare for a good sleep after a productive day. Number 8. Journaling. So since we've tackled writing down your schedule to help you start the day, there's something that you can also do to close the day, and that's to journal. Here are some guide questions you can use when you journal. What did I do today to achieve my goals? What good decisions have I made? What bad decisions have I made, and what have I learned from them? What have I learned from the book that I read today, and how can I put this into practice? By journaling, you'll be able to recall and remind yourself about everything you achieved for the day, and have a clearer picture of where to go next on your path to achieving your goals. These habits, if properly and regularly practiced, can really change lives. From the habits we shared here, which do you think you need to start doing or including in your daily routine? Let us know in the comments section. Also, please like this video if you find it useful. And remember, start small and dream big.